Monsoon may spell romance in the movies, but in the reality, if we live in countries like India or any other humid country, you know, it's a pathetic situation to live by in these places. So this video is all about my monsoon essentials, which I feel would be useful to all of you. Let's start with the video. As much as we love our leather bags and our tote bags, we need to do away with these bags in monsoon because leathers are a big no-no. I'll tell you why. Because during monsoon, when the leather comes in contact with the rain, it clings to your body and moreover, it starts withering out. So you need to protect your leather bags and keep it in a cupboard. As much as you love your heels, but they are a strict no-no this monsoon, and flip-flops are not the thing for monsoon because it's very inconvenient to walk in rains wearing these things. You can always ditch those pretty heels for these rubber shoes, which you can find in a variety of stores and in your local market and also online. You can check them out. Off-shoulders and cold-shoulder be your best bet this winter, monsoon or summer. They are the best thing you can invest your money in, and as well you can always go for bold prints and paisley prints like this one, and of course skater skirts are a must this monsoon. And one more thing, and they scream comfort. Go flirty with the skirt. The skater ones, the cotton ones, the flowy ones works best, but you need to work on the hemline. The skirt should not cross your hemline. That is what you can do for your monsoons. Fabrics play a very important role while it comes to choosing clothes in monsoon, which we tend to forget most of the time. Always go for cotton, lycra, polynylon, but remember one thing, you need to deodorize heavily. Rainy season, no matter how much we love our whites and our maxi skirts and whites are a strict no-no for monsoon season. I tell you guys, do not wear white, and we all know that. I feel, yeah, right, you can wear white only if you know how to layer it. A slip dress is a perfect thing to go in monsoons. Not to forget this, umbrellas are one of the essentials, you know, and they look pretty. I have this one in a newspaper pattern. You can find them in plenty of colors and design, in solid colors, in pretty flower pattern. The easiest way to ace your look during monsoon is to wear brighter hues like pinks and yellows and browns and blues, all the brighter hues and all the sunny colors which we can incorporate in our wardrobe and look really good. The dresses are so in and they are so comfortable. They do not cling to your body, which is so important in monsoon. So it's very important you wear dresses which are comfortable enough and which are breathable enough for you to survive. Do not go for palazzos or for that matter any floor length anarkali or lehenga. They are simply not the thing to be worn in monsoon. Frizzy hair, no care. You can always tie your hair in a really pretty pouch. When it comes to the accessories, you can always ditch the watch with something really funky and cool and playful like these. It will not only add color to your outfit but also going to provide the style factor to it. I know, for people who cannot go really short like me, I have got you covered, don't worry. You can always go for a bright colored kurta like this, or you can also choose colors from yellow, orange, pink, brown. There are plenty of colors around. And you can pair it with a boyfriend jeans, or you can pair it with a capri or jeans like this as I have done. And of course the shoes has to be something with, again, really bright. I went for a red footwear which I bought again from a local market. You can go and buy these. The same pair are there available in Myntra, I guess. So yeah, that's pretty much. I feel this look is the most wearable. You can wear it anytime, anywhere, in the public transport, at a guest house, anywhere. So, and yeah, a chocolate just in case you're having a bad day. Okay, take care and come back again. We meet again on Thursday. Bye bye.